Thank you. Hello. Hey, kids, come on up. Switched microphones. Yeah.
Yeah. see everybody this morning. Do pray for the service. Pray, Lord, just have his way here this morning. We're going to get into the bulletin here. This morning will be a special offer for the youth group. Also, this morning will be business meeting. Tonight we'll be having play practice at 5:30. Everybody needs to know the parts we can so we can go through it. We'll move everything, go through it. We're still going to have youth prayer room at 6:50, okay? So we're still going to do that. We're going to try to do that every Sunday if we can. So, next Saturday, 10 o'clock, anybody wants to, we're going to carry the cross through Main Street and around the circle. Just walk and carry the cross. We got the cross. We just won't carry. Anybody wants to go, that's what we're going to do it Saturday. So you're more than welcome to come. Anybody wants to, we appreciate you coming along with us. But that'll be at 10 o'clock next Saturday, okay? Next Sunday, November 19th, will be Thanksgiving dinner here. November 21st will be our Wednesday night service. We move to Tuesday night. November 26th, special offer for building fund. And December 9th will be church lunch outing and teenagers to go to escape room afterwards. December 10th will be a special offer for youth group. Also, December 10th, business meeting. And December 17th will be the Christmas play. And December 31st, Youth Sunday. And December 31st, special offer for building fund. Anything else? And I'll be directly after service next Sunday. The sign-up sheet, Dee Dee's signing it now. So she's bringing meatloaf. I just put that out there. Do sign up for it and bring plenty. So, church buys me, and everybody usually brings. Anybody wants to make a turkey or ham, let Terry and Melissa know. We always usually, everybody usually brings a dessert and drinks. And plus, bring your drinks Wednesday if you can. But everybody brings a dessert and drinks plus whatever else you want to bring. Just sign up for it back there. We will eat it, I promise. Do remember that. Anything else? Is that it? We'll get into the prayer requests. Ralph Mink, Diane Eisenhower, Laura Sanderson, Brooke Hutchins, Clinton and Adam, Eddie Bentley, Haley Adams, Judy Davis, Kim Bernard, Reason Family, Levi, Ashley, Kelly Sluter, David Wilson, Doug Taylor, Helen Duggar, Cindy Ashley Riley, Kelly Oldham, June Campbell, Daniel Furches, Danny McAlay, Tammy Taylor, Blake and Joanne Atwood, Joanne Pope, Randy Jennings, Larry Hawkins, Willie Gray Adams, Harold Shirley Reich, Jody Dunn, Angie Darty, Kayla Taylor, Robert Sutherland, Ryland Main, Joe McChris, Ralph Hudo, Doug and Murray Miller, Francis Dow, Dennis Lewis, Willie, Carl Higgins, Andy Lowe, Judy Campbell and sister, Ryan, Mike Reynolds, Lucas Barnett, Eddie's family, Ebenezer Christian Home, Tony Jennings, David Saltz, Sue Hensley, Dorothy Keller, Dana Buchanan, Glenda McCulloch, Lucas Perdue, Judy Owens, William Williams, Harley Rankins, Ben Bowers, Kenny and Jane Head, Mandy Flemons, Lester Dunn, Bud Eisenhower, Will Gregg, Sanford and Jane Humphrey, Sue Williams, Frank and Joanna Main, Brenda Lunsford, Andy Osborne, Cliff Tressler, Diane Harmon, Avery Reiner, Emily Church, Osborne family, Gwen Lewis, Abram Whitson, Gary Buchanan, Steve's mother-in-law, Marla, Michelle Worley, David Rohr, Terry Melissa, Crystal Owens, Bronson Alexander, Ross Dow, Willis Lewis, Patty Osborne, Elaine Kirby, Aaron Steele, Randy Lewis, Luella Dunn, Delilah Campbell, Buffy Cornett, Retta, Wendell Caraway, Carl Mass, Dustin Rankins, Alyssa's dad, Mike Lipford, Richard Stidham, Danny Cornett, Margaret Eisenhower, Bob Miller. Nancy Button, John Yates, Paul Gregor's wife, Bud Crosswhite, Gene Buchanan, Nathaniel Rice, Brianna Poor, Unspoken, Tommy Thomas, Israel, Ronnie Henson, Teresa Riley, Carolyn Porter, Savannah Maines, and remember Dennis, he's in the hospital, and remember Baylor. Sierra took him to the doctor's funeral, so he's doing good either. So. Anybody else? Coming up this week. Hey, it's a special old people day, so come on up. Yeah, old people. It's just old people. If you're young, don't come up here. No, I'm kidding. If it's your birthday, come on up. We sing happy birthday. Everybody sing loud. They're old. Shake everybody's hand, tell me glad to see them, whether you mean it or not.
house this morning. Like I said, we appreciate each and every one that's come out to be with us. We thank God for all that He is doing here. We appreciate you for being with us and choosing to join us today. Now, all we do is ask you to serve the Lord. Whatever God bids you to do, that's what we want you to do. If He tells you to shout, shout. If He tells you to sing, sing. Amen. And this is God's house, and this is His time. So maybe somebody here this morning has a song on your heart, something you'd like to do. Come on.
My soul, my Savior.
thou art. Anybody else this morning? Something on your heart? Okay, come on, brother.
Just pray for us. This is the hallows, but for the blood. You know, but for the blood of Jesus, I'd probably be in hell today. God's good. He's wonderful. He's amazing. I love him. Thank you. Would you pray for us? We try to sing this. I have no one to blame. How I long to hide my face. I was so ashamed for all the wrongs I'd done, and I knew I had to pay. I was bound to face hell's fire.
Bibles over to the book of 1 Timothy chapter number 6. 1 Timothy chapter number 6. When you find your place, if you're able, please stand with us for the reading of God's Word. We just want to do that which God would have us to do. We don't want to do any more or any less, because that's what, if we do what God would have us to do, I promise you we'll leave out of here saying what a joy it's been to be in the house of the Lord. I just want to serve Him, amen. Listen, I know sometimes we come in looking to get out, but today I come looking to stay, amen. We may preach 5 minutes, we may preach 5 hours, but whatever we do, we want to worship the Lord, amen. We want to give Him praise and glory. I thank God, like Brother Johnny said, I want to thank the Lord for the revival that we had this week. Thank Him for all that He's done for us and the challenges that's been laid before us. Amen. 1 Timothy chapter number 6, and we're going to begin to read in verse number 11. Verse number 11, the Bible says, "But thou, O man of God, flee these things, follow after righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, meekness. Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life, whereunto thou art called, or also called, and hast professed a good passion, a profession before many witnesses." Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we come to you today, Lord. Just humble ourselves before thee. Thank you for another day and another opportunity, God, just to be able to stand on this eternity. Lord, I thank you for the sweet songs of mine that we've heard this morning, uplifting and magnifying your name. Lord, I thank you for our ear and forward today. I said that we've been fought for this country to give us the freedom to be here today. Lord, I thank you for all that you've done. I thank you for every name that's come in prayer. I pray, God, that each one that the way that you feel. Lord, I know there's some that need a healing. I know there's some that need a restoration. I know there's some, God, that may need a spiritual help. There might be some, Lord, that needs financial help.
But Lord, I pray most of all for those who are going to have a need of salvation. I pray, God, for moving their lives and their around
God. Lord, for any
among us today that does not know the importance of sin, I pray today,
God, something will be said or done.
To point them in the direction
they can get what they need. To get
the end of the family of God.
I pray now
that God will
deliver the word the way
you want to deliver. Prepare
hearts, God, that's ready to be received.
And we'll give you the glory. Our will be done on the mind. Jesus, bless the name of
prayer. Amen. Amen. You can tell there's already demonstrating the service today. We celebrated those that served out there on the battlefield. We served those that put their lives on the line for you and I. But listen, I think there's some others that deserve to be worshipped there, not to be worshipped, but to be prayed for.
You see a lot of time with people that are in our first responders. So, hey, that you see, we're running away from fire, we have firemen running in. When we're running away from gunfire, we have others that are running in. Amen. Hey, for us to determine today who that is, I'm going to tell you right now, the church today has been in flight mode for way too long. Hey, I tell you, Christians today have been in flight mode for way too long. I tell you, it's the time that we stand and we fight, that we stand up for what is right. As I was studying, I was called to remind you of a poem that I read some years ago. I won't read all of it because it's pretty flippy, but I'll give you some of it. It's called, and the title of it is, I Am a Soldier. It says this: I am a soldier in the army of my God. The Lord Jesus Christ is my commanding officer. The Holy Bible is my code of conduct. Faith and prayer and the Word are my weapons of warfare. I have been taught by the Holy Spirit, trained by experience, tried by adversity, and tested by fire. I am a volunteer in this army, and I am enlisted for eternity. I will be translated in this army at the rapture or die on the battlefield. But I will not get out. I will not sell out, be talked out, or pushed out. I am faithful. I am reliable. I am capable. I am dependable. If my God needs me, I am here. If he needs me to teach Sunday school, I am here. To work with the youth, help adults, or just sit and learn. When he calls, I can be used because I am here. I am a soldier. Hey, I think that's some good advice. I think that's some good lessons for us to learn throughout that. There's much more there. And I'll tell you right now, one of the greatest things that God is looking for from you and I is that we'll be willing to stand and fight. Amen. And we can look around us today and we can see what the world is becoming from the fight response. Amen. Hey, we don't want to offend nobody. We don't want to make nobody mad at the Word of God. Hey, we just don't want to hurt their feelings. I'd rather hurt somebody's feelings and know they had a chance to go to heaven than to make them happy and let them die and go to hell. Hey, I'm telling you today, it's time we stood up on that old book. What it stood for then, it stands for today. Amen. What it stood for yesterday, it's going to stand for tomorrow. What he did back over there for the children of Israel coming out of Egypt, he's doing for his children here today. Amen. Hey, I'm telling you, this world wants today, it wants to call good evil and evil good, just like what the Word said. But I'm glad I serve a God today that sin is still sin. Amen. You might just be better at hiding and the world more acceptance of it, but it's still sin. And you know what you need to do. Amen. Hey, if you're here today and you've never accepted the Lord as your Savior, hey, you can dress up, you can pretend to be all you want to be. Amen. I say this week as I was studying, I say, you know, I started to come in here with a stethoscope and a white jacket. You know, I can put those things on and it don't make me nothing. Amen. Hey, there's a lot of people today in the past few weeks over the Halloween time, they dressed up as a lot of different characters. It didn't turn them into something else. They might have looked like something different on the outside, but what was on the inside was the same. I'm going to tell you right now, you can sit in a church house, you can sing in the choir, hey, you can go on every youth trip they are, hey, you can know the Bible from front to back, but unless you know the Lord, you're going to die and go to hell. Hey, I come today, not to sugarcoat nothing, but to take a stand, because I am in the Lord's armory. In the infantry, I may never fly over the enemy, hey, but I'm in the Lord's army. Amen. I can tell you right now, we need more men and women to sign up, get in. A lot of people got their name written down on the roll down here at church. Not many of them got it written down in the Lamb's Book of Life. And look, just because we're in this war, I know everybody in here close to God. They had an emotional experience. They got on the roller coaster, amen. They was down at the bottom, and they went into the church, and things got better, and they just took off, amen. Hey, let me tell you something right now. I don't want you to know it's more than an emotional experience, amen. It's more than just sitting down in the pew. It's a relationship with the Savior. There's something worth fighting for, and I tell you what, the devil's doing everything he can to win. He's doing everything he can to get you, and I'm glad that we've got a victor. I'm glad we've got a captain. I'm glad we've got somebody that will not let us lose.
Never studied how it tries to hurt them. Hey, I'm telling you,
think they got that way because God just come in and drop something in their lap? Hey, no, they got there from earnest prayer and study. They got there by fighting through trouble and tribulation. They got there by learning from their mistakes. Hey, I'm telling you, it's not a time to lay down, but it's a time to stand up and to be faithful and fight the good fight. Listen, it's not always easy. I know when that fight or flight response comes into us, you know what drives that? Fear. Fear is what drives fight or flight. Now, just because we go into battle, just because you see others that will run to the fight, doesn't mean they're not afraid. Does not mean that fear did not come their way. All that means is that they trusted God more than their fear. Amen. More than their fear, they trust the Lord. And more than their fear, they knew there was a need on the other side. They knew somebody needed help. Hey, I'm telling you, there's somebody today that needs help. Hey, it's up to you and I to let them know that there's somebody that can help them. And that man is Christ. God. They don't believe in going on the things of the world. But we want to be on the battlefield for Him.
Amen.
Amen. We want to be on the battlefield for the Lord. There's some things we're fighting for. I got a little more on the priest. I'm going to finish my prayer. Stay strong. But this time I'm going to get weak. But here's what the Lord gave me this week. We need an army. We need an army. hereby, Lord, I'll go. I'll do what you want me to do. Lord, I'll say what you want me to say. Here I am, Lord. Here I am. This all deserves for anyone for any reason. You just want to come down this hall. You want to gather around. You want to lift up his name. Praise him today. Maybe you just want to come down and thank him for being so good. What a Savior. Wow, what a Savior.
Remember here with